Christina Davis, so I'm a member here at Vector Space, but I'm also like a teacher. So as you can see, I'm a mixed media artisan. So I paint just about anything that lets me paint it, or I'll find a way to get that color on it anyhow. I have like a variety of works, everything from projects that I can actually teach to finished projects that I like to sell on Etsy or locally if I can get into a market this year, hopefully. And then I also have, of course, my professional work that I like to display usually in local galleries, which is mainly portraits. Work. And so I do focus usually on women because it's a huge personal subject for me and usually helps me journalize some important aspects about my life as well. I guess I had a very humble beginning. I was really self-taught, so I had a lot of people who loved to just have fun with art, and so they really just inspired me and sparked me to be a teacher, really, and I didn't know it at the time, but I had really great teachers when I was in third grade, and my mom was a homeschooling teacher, and one of her best study habits that she liked to do is to get us creative, build up our confidence with art projects, and so it ended up being a really helpful tool for school, but I got really attached. I really fell in love with acrylic painting, and I just kept taking classes at the Academy Center of the Arts and anywhere I could really get my hands on a lesson to expand my knowledge and my way of thinking about painting. So of course, years later, after I got some courses at college and everything, I started just teaching paint nights and doing face painting out in the community. So it started off with volunteerism. It wasn't even a career plan. So it just grew into that after taking a lot of different avenues of nonprofits and local schools that eventually got offered positions to just go ahead and teach for a lot of departments. So it's been a really awesome journey because I always tell people art tends to have a lot of surprises along the way. You have no idea sometimes where it's going to take you, but the best advice anyone can ever give you is just to take one and see how you do, because the worst is you fail, but you still got to learn something new. So especially during quarantine, I had a lot of people ask me questions of how can I keep doing what we've been doing in the classroom at home until we kind of return back to normal, and I just took it upon myself to like challenge myself and think about projects that made you take a second look around your house. So a lot of these projects are things that you literally could do at home if you wanted to try them, but a lot of my students were just really, you know, happy when I told them we were going to be TPing some things around their home. So this is one of my favorite projects, but this one's tissue paper and wood. And then this one is toilet paper and two boxes of almond milk. And I want to say half and half is in the front. So it took a couple of gulps to get that house done. Like that allow me to introduce a lot of art supplies that a lot of kids have never touched before. So it's really awesome to tell them to be shopping at Home Depot, that they can get art supplies at Walmart, that they don't have to go to the most expensive avenue. I feel like one of the great things I always tell people is that I love about a co-working space like Vector Space really is that you don't always have enough table space for all your projects. So it's definitely good to expand. One, because you get to meet other people who know a ton of cool stuff that you don't know. But the other reason is workspace. So one of the things I don't have at home, which is really awesome, is that I can usually cut a lot of my projects here downstairs. I do not have a circle saw table. I usually have a lot of hand tools because I travel to a lot of my schools and bring a lot of my supplies with me. But one thing that you probably can't do is jam a whole saw into the back of your car, and I don't recommend it to anybody. I definitely would encourage anyone, if they're considering it or working about it, you know, co-working space is a good place to kind of try out having studio space without maybe making a commitment of 1,000 square footage if you don't need it quite yet. A lot of artists, when we're starting out, have a very limited budget. And so one of the most important things about teaching art is also make it reachable, make it obtainable. So this project is actually part of two pieces. It's one really important to talk to kids about recycling and maybe taking a second look at things that they throw inside of a trash can. But one thing that I also really loved about teaching a sculpture that embodied historical preservation aspects to it, I really wanted them to take a second look at their homes. Sometimes when they're in the cars and they're just driving by, you can zone out a little bit. I do it myself. Then I definitely challenge them to ask themselves, if you don't know a palette, think about the palettes that you see along the way. Take photo references of houses you've seen, the ones that you're like, you're always pointing at, you're like, I love this Victorian, or that I've always loved this castle house around the corner. I really wanted kids to talk about street names and start noting a little bit more details. It's really easy when you've never walked the block that if you're just driving by that you'll miss something. Thank you. art can really be a biography piece for you and can really be talking about your life and not feeling like all art's always talking about someone else's life. I definitely always tell my students that my artwork is almost like a journal. I've never been a writer, but I definitely feel as if I put a piece of myself into all of my art projects. And so this one was definitely one, just everything from being able to pick the windows to the color on the doors really allowed you to say, is this home? Is this a place I'm familiar with? Is this a place I'm dreaming about living one day? And I definitely was really inspired by all the results that I saw along the way.